What's going on, guys? I'm here today with some UTSA Dynasty on NCAA Football 13. Of course, it's been a tough season so far for the UTSA Roadrunners, but they've played very competitively this year. They've been in games late, but haven't been able to come away with the victories. Hopefully they cross that threshold soon, but today they have a very tough opponent in number 21 ranked University of Central Florida. And as we get into the action here, we see UTSA on offense early, and Souza's pass is dropped on the right sideline, bringing up third down and 10, and underneath wide open is Brandon Freeman, a hole in the zone defense there. That's good for a UTSA first down. Handoff now Evans Okachi. But as we play these better teams, there's always a consistent trend. Faster defenses, and it's a lot harder for us to get yards, especially on the ground without very fast running backs. And so this drive ends up stalling out after we get a first down. And now UCF takes over the football on offense, and quarterback Blake Bortles, he finds his large tight end. That's Justin Tukes for a first down, plowing over UTSA defenders all the way to the 35, 36 yard line roughly. And now out of the pistol, going to the ground game with Cedric Thompson coming out of the backfield, getting a few yards and bringing up third down and 4. And we bring a blitz. That's what we have to do when we can't man up and play too deep coverage. You have to be able to get to the quarterback, and we do stop them, and they attempt a field goal that goes off the left upright, and that is going to be UTSA football. Now a big momentum shift there to hold UCF and now go on offense. Okocha getting 4 yards here. Definitely need to get a first down here. You can't go 3 and out after a big defensive hold like that. Souza to throw on 2nd down and 6, and it's intercepted. The route was jumped by Gathers, one of their impact defensive players. I had two guys coming there in that area, and I should have thrown it to the shallow receiver in that situation there. And they come on their first play, and they throw it to Cedric Thompson out of the backfield. It's an 8-yard loss, so not a very good start. And then they hand the ball off to Thompson. It's going to be a big first down up the gut, but a flag on the play backs them up even further. So it's going to end up being a 3rd down coming up now in a couple of plays. 3rd down and 28. Playing out. We're going to play too deep now and not try to do too much here on defense. Just don't give up a big play. And Bortles now taking a shot deep towards the end zone, and it's nearly picked off. And so once again, defense successfully holds, although UCF kind of shot themselves in the foot a couple times in that drive. And so now we're back, and Cam Jones, welcome to the game. First catch of the game. That's going to be good for 9.5, bringing up 2nd down and inches, where he pitched it outside Evans Okocha. Room to run. There's a, when they have man coverage like that and there's just nobody over there covering the open space, definitely got to take your opportunities when you can. 3rd and 6 later, Souza, and a great call here to Kenny Harrison on the drag route. Got into the open space, got some separation, and a first down for the Roadrunners. And continuing to play out of 3 wide sets, and Kenny Harrison in the slot gets some more separation in front of the safety there. That's going to be good for a first down for the Runners as they continue this drive into the second quarter. Going to the end zone now for Moeller, and it's overthrown. A good throw though by Souza. It was either going to be Moeller catching it or nobody catching it, and it falls incomplete. Bringing up 3rd down and 7, and Josiah Monroe comes up with a catch, and Souza fits it into him perfectly. He absorbs the hit and catches the touchdown. UTSA up 7-0 now. UCF up to a very slow start on offense, and UTSA has taken advantage to take the lead now with at least 1 touchdown on their first few opportunities. And so after the touchdown, UCF taking over now, and here's Bortles taking off, running through a defender, getting a first down into UTSA territory, trying to find some stability on offense. And now play action, Bortles in the pocket, bomb to the end zone, and touchdown UCF. Burn the corner, beat the safety, touchdown Golden Knights. And not just giving up a touchdown, but a touchdown like that really deflates a team. After going down the field methodically, dink and dunk, get the touchdown, and giving up a touchdown in basically 2 plays, that gives UCF the momentum now. And here's Cedric Thompson running the football effectively, and Bortles is getting this offense rolling. 2nd and 6 to the sideline, and caught by Hall, who had hauled in the touchdown on the previous drive. And now 2nd and short inside the 10-yard line. Underneath to Wharton, and that's good for a touchdown as the Golden Knights extend their lead to 14-7 as we approach halftime now. Souza with a screen pass outside here to Brandon Freeman, but UCF's all over that. Not very good blocking on it either by the receivers. So 3rd down and 12 now, 20 seconds to go in the first half. Underneath, Josiah Monroe, who had the touchdown earlier, makes a first down grab, and we're at least in in distance here to throw a bomb to the end zone, and they brought a blitz here, and we had Okocha open out of the backfield, but I did not see him after seeing a bunch of blitzing defenders come after me. But here is Monroe once again making a catch deep middle, and that's going to set up 7 seconds to go now. First and 10, Souza going long for Monroe again, and he would have been short of the end zone likely if he made the catch there, and we're going to end up kicking a field goal instead. Sean Iano's kick, though, is short. Didn't get all of that one. It's 14-7 going into halftime. Almost got some momentum there towards the end of the half if we could have gotten any sort of points. But nonetheless, we're hanging with UCF, playing very competitive. And how does he make that catch there? That's, I guess, good teams find a way to do some weird things sometimes. And now you can see their offense is really clicking as this play action pass works to perfection, finding Brown for a first down. And then Bortles back to throw on first and 10 outside to Tukes once more for a first. And now inside of the red zone, the Roadrunners defense needs to clamp down here and hold them to a field goal at the most. And this jump ball is nearly caught and almost picked off at the same time, I guess. Third and 8, though, for Bortles. Wants end zone. He goes underneath and said to Perryman. And a good job of tackling by the UTSA defenders. A gang tackle there. And that does hold UCF to a field goal, but the Roadrunners have to get their offense going once more. They have one touchdown drive, and here's Okocha making a catch underneath, that very tough one, making it for 6 yards. Second down and 4, and Souza wanted the screen, and it wasn't open initially. The cornerback came down, and then pressure got to him. And so 3rd and 14, Souza sacked once more off the right edge, and that's going to give the ball back to UCF, as they have an opportunity now to really put some damage on the UTSA Roadrunners defense, and to put this game potentially out of reach for our offense. And so we come back now with a blitz. I come to Tristan Wade on a strong safety blitz on 3rd and short, and it works. And so we hold UCF again to a field goal attempt now to make it a 13-point game. Kick is up, and it is short. And so once again, UTSA's defense, though, is really stepping up today. And the offense just has to get some more points on the board. Cam Jones here making a first down. We're almost to the fourth quarter, by the way. A nice shotgun call here to Evans Okocha. That is good for a first down. And now 2nd down and 5. Counterplay Okocha left side looking for the first down. Not quite there. Bringing up 3rd down and short. But we'll give it to him one more time. Handoff. First down Okocha as we're inside the red zone now. And also inside of 5 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the football game. Souza, though, under pressure. He goes down. Loss of 8 on the sack. Bringing up 2nd down and 18 as we bring up 4 wideouts now. Souza's pass is in traffic, nearly picked off. He won Brandon Freeman. 3rd down and 18. Okocha to his left. Souza under pressure and sacked. I might have been able to hit Josiah Monroe there on the right slot. But a lot of pressure has been caused by this Knights front 4. And they have 6 sacks on the day. And most importantly, they knocked us out of field goal range. So we have to take a shot to the end zone. And we had 2 guys wide open. And Souza's pass is overthrown. Could have been a very big game-changing play there. But instead, it's UCF football. And Cedric Thompson out of the backfield, the first down. 3rd and 7 coming up now. 2 minutes to go in the game. Bortles finds Hall for a first down on the slant route. And that's going to be good for another first down. And so we're inside of a minute to go. Handoff Cedric Thompson. They're running the football, running this clock. And I must not have been paying attention when I was playing. But I have all 3 timeouts, and I was not using them. But UCF was still getting first downs, so it wasn't like a big game-changing thing. But it was another tough game we played where we just could not get enough offense going. And the defense, I thought, played very well. They held them to 17 points, and they had 2 missed field goals as well. But the offense, I mean, just has to get going a little bit better. Only 1 turnover in this game, but we had trouble running the football, and that really made our offense one-dimensional. And other than Josiah Monroe, there wasn't much success for us in the passing game. And so UTSA falls to 0-4 on the year. They've played some very good games, or some very close games, I should say, but just haven't been able to find that first win of the season. But they've had a pretty tough schedule so far, playing against teams like Colorado and UCF. They had a couple of tough games in the conference. And so we're going to do some recruiting now towards the end of this episode. And I'm looking at receiver here with Randy Jones, a very good prospect, a 4-star guy from Corpus Christi, whom we are first on his watch list right now. And we also need some help at the guard position, and so we're definitely going to be looking for some run-blocking talent there, hopefully, to help pave the way for our ground game we have. And also defensive ends, we can start getting some more pressure. It definitely hurts to have Jerron Harris graduate after last season, after he was such a beast in year 1. And here I'm looking at a linebacker, and you guys know I have an infatuation with fast linebackers. He's got 87 speed, and I would like to move him to the outside because we have some young prospects at middle linebacker like Dominic Carter. And so maybe I'd move this guy to like an outside linebacker spot, and then we're going to look at some corners here. And you guys know my philosophy here, as always. I love tall cornerbacks that can play man coverage, bump and run. It's what I want to be able to do, but it's always a work in progress, especially with a team building from the ground up like UTSA. And so we're now going to look at, finally, a punter, Obadiah Jackson, and he's from Illinois. And that's going to take us to the end of the episode, guys. Next, let me play the Houston Cougars, who have only played 2 games this year. We've played 4. Hopefully, we can get our first win on the season next week in a Conference USA matchup. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please do leave a like. And here are a couple more videos for you guys to check out. Left side is a channel update. Very important stuff there. Go check that one out. On the right side, I have some Evans Okacha I uploaded earlier today. Check out those 2 videos, guys. And thank you for watching. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. And I'll see you guys next time. Have a great day.